Cause I don't want no peace. I need equal rights and justice. I need equal rights and justice. I got to get it.
Equal rights
and justice. I'm fighting for it.
Equal rights
and justice. Nobody knows, but everybody fighting to reach the top. How far is it from the bottom? I don't want no peace.
I want equal rights and justice.
Tell me who are the criminals? I really don't see them. I don't want no peace. I need equal rights and justice. We got to get
equal rights
and justice. And there'll be no crime.
Equal rights
and justice. Down in Angola,
equal rights
and justice. Down in Botswana,
equal rights
and justice. Down in Zimbabwe,
equal rights
and justice. Down in Rhodesia, equal rights and justice. Right here in Jamaica.
Crying out for justice.
Everyone is crying out for peace, yes.
None is crying out for justice.
I don't want no peace.
I need equal rights and justice.
I need
And Right now.
And
Right now, the UNC virtual political platform is the most watched online.
Should you call these elections while thousands of citizens of our country are outside of the country? You take away their right to vote.
We are the voice for the voiceless and those who have been left out and left behind.
They shut down TDC. Hundreds sent home. ArcelorMittal shut down. Thousands were unemployed. Petrotin shut down. A lying prime minister. Lying prime minister who said the government is not shutting down Petrotin.
Watch us, like us, stay with us. The United National Congress virtual campaign on the ballot. 7:30 p.m. Thursday on this station. Why wait? Now is the time.
And to you on the radio, and to you watching on TV, do not adjust your dial. It is Anil you're seeing right here, live and direct. Never went anywhere. Because the douglAR can talk either way. Because the douglAR can talk either way.
Anil Robert!
Good evening and welcome to douglAR Politics. I tell you, we starting. 729, we starting 729. You understand that video there on the start was from 2016. They lying on Anil since 2014, 2015, 2016. Judy Raymond, you print a big front page Sunday. I forget I look good in suit and thing, girl. I look good there, girl. But what you print? What's the allegation? You show your colors one time, all the douglAR ask you is in a two-party state. If you have two leaders and you have an editor who is closer to one, Archie, you know, if you're closer to one than another, if you feel as a journalist, as an editor, as a lady of integrity, someone, go ahead, Archie, you can fling it up, as someone who understands the principles of fairness, balance, impartiality, integrity, morality, apparent bias. All I do is ask you a question, Anil, answer all your questions. What is the front page? What is the allegation against Anil? Lawyers read through the article, 3,000 words. They can't find something to sue you on because you so print a bag of nonsense, a bag of nothing in a front page. You ain't put Delcy and Rowley and Smallpin and how they lie, and an next plane might come, and if central bank people from Venezuela or agriculture people from Venezuela, the US come, Miss Chung, the representative from the State Department, warning our business people in Trinidad and Tobago not to do business with Venezuela. Now Rowley is saying we must get behind his foreign policy. Judy Raymond, and I told you I will research. I used to boast, I have to apologize to all you, I get updated information. I used to buff The Guardian because since last year August, The Guardian running some fake news now. But how them is the number one newspaper and all kind of rubbish and how is the most value per read. I don't know how you judge value per read and all of them things. But Guardian was lying, right? Because Guardian perennially, their daily circulation is 17,000 for the last 20 years, okay? They never really get up above that. If they get up above that now, well, it's because I'm now hearing that the Newsday fall. Remember I tell all about the Newsday was selling 49,000 papers. The Express is number one all the time for the last 25, 30 years. And they go at about 79,000 papers per day. Newsday, I am hearing from four different sources. Judy Raymond, is it true that 49,000 daily circulation that Anil was talking about is now Monday to Saturday 15,000? But you know, you remember you ain't good at a little bit, girl. No wonder you like Rowley. You both always said I'm married and have children. Both always the same kind of incompetent. You must like Rowley more than Kamala. But I ask you a question. So they'd gone down to 15,000. What was sad for me is that the front page you put me on, with nothing to say about me, no allegation. And Judy Raymond, in order to have an investigation, there must first be an allegation. You see, like, there's an allegation that the Bridgemans deal with the ferries at $26,500 per day for the first 12 months and renewed three consecutive times at 6 months at $22,000, that deal was crooked. So says Rowley, not Anil, not the Dougla. All your wannabe Oreo black man prime minister who play more golf and go on more holiday than all your, take everything from black people, from work, petrol train, job, laptop, baby milk, everything he take from poor people. But all you say vote for he because he black. And I must vote for he because I balled like he. All right, if all you want to talk that, Judy Raymond. Rowley lied to the Tobagonians and said that Bridgeman's crooked deal, as he described it, went through the cabinet process. For y'all who don't remember, cabinet process is the charter party agreement comes, it goes to cabinet by the Minister of Works and Transport, cabinet discusses it because it's a big money thing, it goes to FNGP, which is a meeting, finance and general purpose meeting, which is held on a Monday, and then they debate it and they discuss it. If people in the FNGP are not happy, ministers not happy, they have to come back, public servants and the port board, everybody have to come and organize and talk. And when it gets through, if FNGP approves, it then comes back to the cabinet where it is approved. It stays there, and 1 week later, you open a brown leather folder with Minister of Sport on it, and you have some pink pieces of paper of the notes that were approved from the week before. So you come now and you confirm it. Rowley said that was the process. Tonight could be a sweaty night because it's pressure and pace down in the Dougla politics. 2 weeks later, after telling the Tobagonians that lie, Rowley went in the Joint Select Committee of Parliament with his steward Small Pin Young right by his side. And when he was questioned, Wade Mark, I think, was questioning him, he said, no. Where was I? And Small Pin leaned into Rowley's ear and whispered softly, "You were in Tobago. We were in Tobago. What about all you doing in Tobago? I'll go investigate that, you know." And Rowley then said, "Oh, yes, I was in Tobago, and the charter party agreement came in on a Friday at about 5 p.m., and they called me, and I said, I approved it. I gave prime ministerial approval, the only human being in the country who could do that, who could have authorized $26,500 per day, every day for 365 days, so a total of about $67 million is the prime minister. He describes that as crooked. So I now make an allegation that he consummated the crooked deal. You see, Judy Raymond, that is how you make an allegation. I dare you to make an allegation against Anil that he take a pencil from the government. A pencil, a rubber eraser, 1 cent. Here's another allegation. That a man at Attorney General sat down in a cabinet. He recused himself, whatever all you want to call that. And the cabinet of which he formed the part, because a cabinet is formed with a prime minister and attorney general. If he recused himself, then there was no cabinet meeting. So they just lie so much. Because if he recused himself, there can be no standing attorney general. You understand? You all getting my drift? So for Johnny Sukaran lie. Because if he had to recuse himself, the prime minister would have had to write the president, say that we need an attorney general, because without an attorney general, there is no cabinet. Therefore, anything that was discussed by a cabinet without an attorney general does not exist. Are you following me? But anyway, the cabinet without the attorney general, which is not a cabinet, approved $23 million for Al-Rawi to rent his own building. Taxpayers' money. See? Anil, I dare you say Anil have a pencil that don't belong to him now. I even leave my phone number and then they, when I resign, because I didn't want them say, because you know, government has paid late. I didn't want them to say, because the ministry has paid a minister phone bill, because we had a talk to our constituents and think that's valid. I leave the phone there. It's my number, I don't want to get a new number. And I had plenty of call me and you couldn't get through, because I say I don't want nobody say I gone with the people thing. You understand? So don't get tied up with Anil. So Judy Raymond, you see, I was talking to my partner on Dougla Politics before, my Rasta boy partner. He is a very intelligent fellow, intellectual. He's like with a set of bright boys and so on. Stanley Augustus. But I call him Stanley Mervyn Augustus Manning. You understand? Because he is taking a kind of PNM stance, right? And he's always tell me this. Boy, Anil, Kamala, and her government, you included, all your real perform, boy. If it wasn't Fazal Karim and Tim Gopi singing education across the board, from early childhood to grants to textbook to special needs children grant for their school, to the UTT funding, to TechVoc, to MIC centers, NESC centers with David Lee, to laptops, to food, school feeding, everything, all you perform good, boy. He say in sport, well, you mash up. He say Jack Warner pave road like never before, right through Suruj Ramachandran, carry that on too. And all you say Suruj Ramachandran don't like African, but he put more URP projects in Lavanti by the train line, in Malabar, in Pinto, in Arima, in Maloney, all over this country. As soon as Rowley, the black man prime minister, reached, URP cut. All you know that better than me. And they coming back to tell you vote. As we say, Maloney. I wasn't going to say this yet, you know. This show will go on longer than an hour. Eh? But I go sweat. Don't mind if I wipe my forehead and think. Archie, I've on a hot light there and think. The air conditioner kicking up like Kick M Jenny. Maloney, I don't know how to. Let me calm down, eh? I don't know why this so called black African government, this is douglAR politics, right? We have to eliminate race from voting. Here's another reason why. Maloney, I know you ain't going to vote for me and Kamala. Whoever we put there. We lost. Camille go win, right? Okay. Whether she gone in the bank with the 143,000 and she lie on the statutory or not, whether she tell the truth, whatever, she go win. Okay, Maloney. Forget that. I ain't telling you this for vote because I know I lost, right? I in the politics long enough to know I lost my Maloney brothers and sisters because I ain't that good to convince all you to vote on policy and things so easy, right? Because they pumping all you that them who look so don't ever vote for them. Even though this one who look like you hitting your cough in your face, enjoy the cough and say at least, again cough from somebody who look like me. Well, I different. I like to read and follow policy. My people in Maloney, and remember who talking to you. And if some of all your young people don't know, I am the highest qualified swimming coach in the history of the Caribbean. I am level 5 senior World Swim Coaches Association and level 5 senior American Swim Coaches Association. I am also NCP level 3 in Canada. And I've been to 4 Olympics coaching. I've won an Olympic bronze medal and had 3 different athletes in finals in the Olympics. Okay. So I know a bit about swimming. My people of Maloney, a set of ministers came with spade and break ground to build a swimming pool for all you. I want all of you all to go and look at the picture that they put there. They are coming to build the same thing that they built for the black people in Lavanti. A 6-lane, 25-meter pool with an average lane width of 1.47 meters. Let me tell you, the last time globally that a 6-lane pool was built was in 1961. Since then, swimming pools of magnitude have been built with 10 lanes, at worst, 8 lanes. They are coming to build rubbish for black people again. Why? Y'all don't deserve a 10-lane, 2-meter-wide pool with proper racing lane ropes so that the waves when you swim would flow over guttering with a salt filtration system rather than chlorine to burn all my little children's eyes that will make sure that the pool stays pristine and clear even if 10,000 people use it per day. Make sure and wear your caps and so on. Why are they coming to build a pond for y'all? And then telling you, I didn't even listen to the speech, but I'm sure my people are Maloney. They tell you this is a world-class facility. Remember Rowley went in Lavanti and tell them, this is a world-class facility. We're going to make Olympic medals someday. Stop mamagaing black people. On top of that, the pool in Lavanti, he tell them, well, we don't want the people of Lavanti to manage it. We are going to bring the Coast Guard and Army to protect it because we don't want it to turn green. I built, under Kamala Prasad Bisesa government, the greatest aquatics facility in the Western Hemisphere. Y'all go and view it. Children go and tour it. In the USA, there's no facility like that. Understand that. Look at the U.S. Olympic trials. They swim in that indoor thing, chunky, chunky. That aquatic center is the best in the Western Hemisphere. In the United States of America, there is not one better than that in Couva, that National Aquatic Center. You know the PNM turned that green 2 years ago, August? It turned green, they couldn't manage it and so on. It shut down the air conditioning, the cycling velodrome that I built with Kamala. They cut the, up to now, the air conditioner not working. It's like down here in Atlantic, sweating, men on the bike pedaling for Olympics and sweating and skating on the wood. So why? I know you're all going to vote for them, you know, but you, why are you taking the mamagism? So the people in Maloney only worth a pun and only lying to them and tell them world class. How can world class be six lanes? How can world class only be average depth of 1.4 meters? How can world class not have have a viewing window? You see, coaches like me, we need to see from underneath to see what you're doing under the water. Every pool, go by the aquatic center, you'll see a glass with a room where coaches could go down with audiovisual equipment and film, according to my former member of parliament for Lavanty West of the PNM, Nylon Hippolyte. Them does film. Go and film the children them from underneath. All you have that in Maloney, all you have that in Lavanty, but the black man who all you vote for coming to tell all you that is world class. But Al-Rawi get $38 million to outfit his own building for all your black people to pay rent to him, $23 million for 3 years. Al-Rawi by himself get $61 million. The whole of Maloney, them going and build a pool for $7 million. Even Patrick Manning, who built a Kokie pool back in 2007, 2006 to 8, $30 million he spent back then. At least he care about the people in Kokie. So let me get back to the point. So my people in Maloney, I dare anybody in the PNM to challenge me on that. Challenge me on that. You're billing absolute nonsense, Noel Garcia, for the people. You better take down that. Take down that board. Go back and redesign, rebudget, and build something good for the people in Maloney. All you wicked, man. My boy Stanley Augustus has always say, Anil boy, all you perform good. But the perception is that, oh God, Kamala and all your boy, all your Indian thief, boy. Oh God, all your thief. Remember, I wonder Archie are giving you a hard thing because you may not have it there. When Rowley showing the graph, we used it about 2 weeks ago, but I like to remind you all, Archie might be able to find it, but I really didn't plan. He have other things planned for me. But I'm going off the cuff right now. They say, boy, all your real perform, boy. But all your thief, boy, all your corrupt. But yet Rowley show a graph where cash in bank during Kamala from 2010 went so 2014, it came down a little bit in 2015. And then after 2015 to 2018 or 19, it do so under he. I thought when you had thief, cash in bank, cash does empty. I didn't know thief does drop money in bank. Thief does fill bank. So that is the perception. So I tell you all, the perception is created by the mass media. Yes, we have social media now that is battling and getting some truth. But mass media is still the power, like the Newsday. So you see how Judy Raymond can put the perception. Judy Raymond put Anil on her front page. Live spot, 400 million. Police coming to talk to me. Police can talk to me anytime. 6 years there, talk to me. If they want to come and talk to me, they could come and talk COVID. I could make a little breakfast for them. They could drink some sorrel, play with the dogs. But let me tell you something. Police don't talk to people of which there's no allegation, Judy Raymond. So you could play your stupid game, but you're such a dum-dum. I set a little trap for you and you jump right in for the whole country to see the games that you are playing with the Newsday. And the Newsday, I would like to talk to the owner of the Newsday, Mr. Castani. Mr. Castani is a good man. He's a PNM, but a good PNM, an honest PNM. A man of integrity. I met him since 1993, but I really got to know him in 1996 Olympics in Atlanta before I put the first black woman into a swimming final in history, Leah Martindale of Barbados. In history of swimming, since 1896 when Pierre de Coubertin started back the modern Olympics, Leah Martindale of Barbados, coached by the douglAR, is the first black woman to ever make an Olympic individual swimming final. All you understand? Black lives matter, right? I was there coaching and getting ready. Swimming is first. Gene Samuel was there getting ready for his last Olympics. And Mr. Castani, the owner of the Newsday, was the manager coach. I was, for my swimmers, manager, coach, psychologist, everything. He come to me, boy. He say, boy, Gene feeling stiff. Anil, you go massage Gene, boy. I say, of course, Trinidad Tobago, no problem. So he go and they put him on the table. All he ever massage, hard concrete, like TCL, or my boy Stefan Reese, where's your concrete? Rock hard concrete. Gene Samuel leg like concrete. Your boy going on a massage in them leg to get the lactic acid out. When I finish after an hour, I dripping sweat, the whole place wet, I burn. I went straight in my room and sleep in the village. Mr. Castani appreciated that. Why am I telling you? Because the Newsday, up to 2 years ago, I would tell all you, go and listen to any tapes I say on the radio. The Newsday was the most fair and balanced newspaper in Trinidad and Tobago, even though it owned by Castani, who's a PNM. I even said on the radio on douglAR Politics that I would have to even say, back then, the Newsday kind of favoring me and Kamala, 55-45. Them going and hire a lady called Judy Raymond. Put she up now. That woman there. And since then, the Newsday gone 98, Rowley, 2% Kamala. Since that woman reached, as illustrated Sunday, with a front page. What end when you put a front page Sunday? And Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, it has story coming, moving. Where the story gone? You drop it like a hot potato, Judy Raymond. You went Oxford, but you're a dunce girl. You understand? The Newsday gone down from 49,000 papers down to 15,000. You firing all kind of people. Everybody have the Newsday in court. Mr. Castani, I am now asking you. As the PNM owner of the Newsday, you're losing money. And here you're going to lose more money now. Ladies and gentlemen, the douglAR, I have to buy the Newsday, Express, and Guardian. Because Christopher Sion, my brother who passed away recently, who used to be on the controls for douglAR Politics at Power 102, he told me, Anil, you have to buy it because you have to read it and you have to analyze it and give us the information and so on. So I will continue to buy it. But anybody supporting out there who wants a fair country, who wants impartial media, me and one nobody on my friend or Kamala friend, you know. But we saying 50-50, equal treatment, integrity, good journalism, move with honesty, right or wrong, deal with it. Rowley Prime Minister, but that ain't gonna be for much longer. Kamala Prime Minister, be fair, not this bag of nonsense. So I am asking Mr. Castani now. And I am challenging you, Mr. Castani, because after this program, your daily circulation of 15,000, I bet you by Friday, your daily circulation will go down to 11,000. I am saying to my people who want fair media, who want balanced media, who want truth, who want to know the truth so they can make a decision and vote on whoever is better to improve their lives, do buy the Newsday. The douglAR say, do buy the Newsday. I go buy one copy and tell all you what it say. Until such time as the Newsday shows that they return into their roots of fairness, equity. Mr. Castani, PNM Castani, your brother Anil, challenge you. We coming back.
Right now, the UNC virtual political platform is the most watched online.
Should you call these elections while thousands of citizens of our country are outside of the country? You take away their right to vote.
We are the voice for the voiceless and those who have been left out and left behind.
They shut down TDC. Hundreds sent home. ArcelorMittal shut down. Thousands were unemployed. Petrotin shut down. A lying prime minister. Lion Prime Minister said the government is not shutting down Petrotin.
Watch us, like us, stay with us. The United National Congress virtual campaign on the ballot. 7:30 p.m. Thursday on this station. Why wait? Now is the time.
So Judy Raymond, you're so special. You're so special, you're so special. I should have sing a little dance hall. Understand this. The reason you cannot make an allegation 6 years in or 60 years down the road against Anil Roberts, because Anil Roberts did nothing wrong, not one red cent other than my salary as a minister. I did not even utilize the 50,000 that you could use in entertainment and so on. I did not even buy the two car that you could get in 5 years. I buy one car tax-free and I give my ex-wife because I'm my two children and let them ride safe. I still am my old Jaguar. So understand, when you're calling people name, be very careful, Judy Raymond. Because the reason why your story is bogus and will always remain bogus, and Anil Roberts will not be interviewed by no police and no investigation, is that we in the UNC follow proper corporate governance practice. So in live sport, clung Judy Raymond, there was a live sport board. There was a director of live sport duly hired through the proper procedure of advertisement, committee, public servants, and interviews. Deputy director, and an entire organizational structure. They were in charge of all the proper procurement or whatever, and decisions on HR decisions, procurement, goods and services, catering. They have people there for that. The payment system was under the sport company, which had a board of 9 people, Judy Raymond, and they had a CEO, and all money coming out went through that and through the permanent secretary of the Ministry of Sport. So the minister, this minister, respected the system. Yes, it's my brainchild. So you vex, if all you vex that I came up with something to help poor black people stop killing themselves and stop shooting one another and trying to get out of the gangs, to put food in their belly, put money in their pocket, identify talent, get them counseling, get them in community, get them fit and healthy, and move them into good jobs. If all you vex with me for that, well, good. I glad all you vex with me. But that's where the minister's input stop. So if ever there was anything wrong, and forget the audit because it was thrown out. Imagine the Newsday's printing after going through court and the High Court quash a audit, which means it does not exist. The information was useless and worthless. And if you want more information, you have to go and do something else. The Newsday on Sunday still trying to print a quashed audit. That's what Judy Raymond did. Imagine printing a quashed audit. To do what? Create a perception and printing Anil picture twice. Thank you. Yeah, no, we gone. Oh, let's share the live. And Ellie done with Judy Raymond one time. And Castani, you go deal with she. Because Newsday gone through. Imagine when Guardian selling more daily papers than you. You know you ain't good. And you know where she was before? Guardian. Wherever she go, nobody does buy papers. So Judy Raymond, good luck to you. Now, you see the difference? Let's now analyze Keith Christopher Rowley and his running the government. Let's see his procurement practice. I already told you about one where he authorized by himself on the phone the entire Bridgman's Cobo Star contract that he described as crooked. Okay, so if they have an investigation into that, you have to go and ask and interview Rowley, because he was actively involved in the payment system. What about Rowley and Smallpin fly down to Australia? Both of them tour Austal and Incat. They say, yes, we're going to buy vessels. We're borrowing money from Australia. So they come to light on it to say it's a government-to-government relationship. A government-to-government relationship does not have totally 100% private companies. So they lie to all you. They come back here and they tell Austal and Incat, bring the bids and hand it to Smallpin Young, who chairing a ministerial committee who would analyze the bids. When Smallpin Young come to tell the country what the government and the cabinet had agreed, he said, and I quote, well, we noticed, the committee noticed when we opened both bids, that Austal's bid was higher by some 17 million US or Australian. And we contacted them, alerted them to Incat's price. Is that sounding weird to y'all? Is that sounding wrong? Do y'all know what bid rigging is? Do you know that the Central Tenders Board Act of Trinidad and Tobago is still in effect right now, even though the procurement legislation has not been proclaimed? And in the Central Tenders Board Act, bid rigging is illegal. So Stuart Smallpin, Bright Boy Young, says, yes, we called them and we got them to lower their price. And we decided, Smallpin to Rowley, Smallpin in the office of the Prime Minister, who traveled with him to Rowley, and the cabinet say, yes, man, give one each. And then he come and tell all you, we save all your money, you see how good we is, vote for we. Now, police need to go and ask Smallpin and Rowley something, because their hands were all in that. They all up. There's no corporate governance. There's no best practice. There's no Ministry of Finance procurement rules. The idea of procurement is, the longer the chain, the more people involved, the harder it is to thief. Because you got whistleblowers, you are honest people. If you are 12 people in a chain, you might have 3 thief. You might have 6 honest and 3 in between. So it's more likely that somebody going to say no. Like when they did a tender and AV Oil won and the Galicia came second. Remember that? When they were crashing the sea bridge. And then somebody on that board that was then fired by Rowley, right? The board that did the right thing. Somebody said, but how AV could win? AV Oil, the same one that Kamala had hold up with the petrol thing with the 100 million. How they could win? They didn't tender with a boat. Them just tender a number. No vessel. So somebody on the board noticed that and said, no, they did their job correctly. You see, when you have board, somebody honest, smart, they pelt out AV and Galicia won. You know what the PNM did? They scuttled the contract and said, nah, nah, that ain't good. Once you see a government scuttling contract, that is a red flag that says the person them want to win did not win. You see now, police could go and ask Rowley, but why was that scuttled? Why did you, as Prime Minister, head of the cabinet, fire that board and replace it with another board? You see, Judy Raymond, that's how allegations work, an investigation. You cannot investigate without an allegation. What about Colmimbert, Smallpin, LaHunt, and Shamfa Kujo, ministers procuring the Galleon's Passage? All you remember that? I just told y'all that ministers don't get involved in that. Because ministers are decision makers. The idea of good governance, transparency, and accountability means you keep the decision makers as far away from the suppliers as possible. But since Rowley's swearing to be Prime Minister, all he doing is meeting with CEO, suppliers, and all them gas company, oil company, Chinese company, construction company, all he doing is meeting all over the place with CEO and people who in charge. And all you're balling Kamala and them thief. So understand this. Rowley, after crashing the sea bridge, scuttling 4 tenders, telling y'all that the Galicia people wanted to hold Trinidad and Tobago to ransom. All nonsense. They bid twice and they won twice. And your government, PNM government, pelled them out to put Tobagonian on barge. The barge takes so long to reach Tobago, people thought that they had to take out a U.S. visa. They thought they reached Miami. They're looking for a man to say, hey, what are you doing here? How long are you going to stay? No, it's Tobago they reach. You see the problem? And then Rowley, your Prime Minister, comes to you and the media, Judy Raymond and these editors, decide that what he's saying makes sense. He says, I'm not letting the board go. I'm going to put a ministerial committee to lease a fast ferry. If you all understand what I'm saying, you all should be shocked. Your eyes should be opening. Ministers to procure. So he put this ministerial team with Smallpin and Colmimbert, who previously as Minister of Works and Transport under poor Patrick Manning went and buy water taxi. They sue the militia, whatever it is. They sue a sailor meter, $45 million and about $65 million trying to fix it. It must be still tied up down in Chakaramas. They can't even move it because it go drop down and sink. That was Colmimbert. And only want to call Anil name. All you better rest Anil. Eh? So ministers went and purchased. Now imagine this. The instruction was lease a fast ferry. Them purchased a slow boat to China. The Guardian's passage to Bogonia don't even want to go on it. They prefer stay in Trinidad. Because that is the slowest, worst ride. Anytime the breeze blows, it had to turn back. Rowley then come after his minister spent $120 million without board, tender committee, advertisement, open tender, evaluation committee, permanent secretary, cabinet note, FNGP, cabinet approval, cabinet confirmation. Without that, just Rowley minister say, hey, $120 million? Yeah, boy, we buying. Buying scrap iron, old battery buying, and all you're calling other people thief, all you're sick. Then Rowley come and sit down in a conversation with the Prime Minister. When he started to talk like a convent girl, like the idol thing, he sit down and cross his legs. He said, if y'all thought that was a farce, very well, you'll be surely disappointed. That was never intended to be a farce ferry. We bought that for the port that we ain't built in Toko yet. The douglAR cannot make this up, you know. And all of them studying now. To make all your vote for them, they paving road now. So forget all of that. Forget all what they say. They pave your road, vote Rowley. That's what they think of us. That's what they think of my people in Maloney. My people in Maloney. All you make them go back and redesign that. And hear me. Take a pen and pencil quick. You want 10 lanes. You want an average from 1.4 meter depth down to 3 meters depth. You want racing lane ropes that eliminate the waves. You want flow over guttering so when my children dive in and the way the water is displaced, it don't bounce off no wall. You don't want no concrete wall with no lip. You want the water to flow over and there's a catchment area where the water flows over, goes down inside, comes through the filtration. Okay? So tell them, no, don't dig no spade here. Fire burn that garbage all you're going and put for we. Maloney want a good pool. Tell Camille if she could have buy good wig in 2007, all you want a good pool. Wives of ministers getting contract, big contract, $440 million here. The I think, wow, Franklin can wipe. And man, ministers separating himself from the wife. I thought when all you marry, all you just take two candles and light one big fat one and say, the two shall become one. But when you're in a PNM cabinet, all of a sudden, all you like back the two. Nah, die my wife. Die not me. And Kamala and them thief, Anil thief. All you give me a rest now. I think you all get the idea. The last one, small pin. You all saw it about 3 or 4 years ago. Small pin. Write a letter to PTSC board recommending contractor be paid even though verification process was going on a letterhead and sign it. A minister getting actively involved in money things. That's an allegation that warrants investigation. Judy Raymond make an allegation against Anil because I want Castani money, boy. I dare you, girl. Your Oxford dance, you must go down in history as the most dotage graduate of Oxford. I'm very sorry. Moving right along. I'm going to take a little break here because I'm real sweating, boy. The douglAR like on fire. Let me take a little break and I'm coming back. I'm going to wipe down my bald head. And all they don't say I look like Rowley, you know, I better looking than Rowley. And I wear yellow. Rowley, pave more road, boy. The people will vote.
Right now, the UNC virtual political platform is the most watched online.
Should you call these elections while thousands of citizens of our country are outside of the country? You take away their right to vote.
We are the voice for the voiceless and those who have been left out and left behind.
They shut down TDC. Hundreds sent home. ArcelorMittal shut down. Thousands were unemployed. Petrotin shut down, a lying prime minister. Lying prime minister who said the government is not shutting down Petrotin.
Watch us, like us, stay with us. The United National Congress virtual campaign on the ballot. 7:30 p.m. Thursday on this station. Why wait? Now is the time.
Hi, I'm Sean Sobers, your UNC candidate for San Fernando West. I'm a born and bred San Fernandian. I went to school at St. Paul's Anglican School, Primary School on Harris Street in San Fernando. I then completed my secondary school education at Presentation College on Carib Street in San Fernando. And now I'm a practicing attorney at law on Harris Street in San Fernando in my own chambers. I joined United National Congress because I truly believe in the vision of our leader, Ms. Kamala Prasad Bisesa, that by building communities, we will build cities, and by building cities, we will change our country. San Fernando is no different. In the words of the current MP, San Fernando is suffering from institutional rot. But what he hasn't said is that he is a representative of that institution that has left San Fernando to rot. Let us change the landscape of San Fernando for the people of San Fernando, by the people of San Fernando.
We fed up by these people and all the bag of lies and everything that they're doing wrong. They try.
Let us get TNT working again.
Never want to take the blame. Be frustrated now, don't want
to. You know, since mischief was afoot, yesterday on the radio, I did something that I ain't do. I on the radio since 1996 doing football and thing. Then with Sprang Along and Christopher Sion on the Power 102 afternoon drive, I was on from like 2005, 2004 November till 2010 March. Sport TV thing. I never like to talk about myself, but I realize with Judy Raymond playing games and trying to cast aspersions on me, that yesterday on the radio, I gave a little insight into who Anil Roberts is to the young ones. And I'm going to do a little bit more because I got 7 calls yesterday. People between the ages of 18 and 26. They say, but Anil, we didn't know you swim. We didn't know black man could have swim so. And since so long you swimming, since you're 10 years old. I said, no, since I'm 4. But I win my first national title at 8. And then my first national team at 9. But since they wanted to know, understand this, let me give you one or two more stories about Anil Roberts. I gave you all the story about when I was doing World Cup cricket with B-Mobile, and they take my accreditation in Antigua, and B-Mobile had already paid me for the whole tournament, but I couldn't do the last 3 stops. The contract, I could have kept the money. Ask them at B-Mobile. I gave them back the remainder of the money. So don't call Anil name in no nonsense, no rubbish, all your disrespectful clowns. When I was a minister in government, and asked Fazal Karim this, Fazal Karim was the Minister of Science and Tertiary Education. He was looking to do something for his nurses. He needed a venue to do some, you know, really get his nurses qualified and so on. He needed a facility. He came to me, he said, Anil, I see you have a thing in El Dorado there, you know, a complex on the youth and so on. I really need it for the nurses. I went straight, called the permanent secretary, I said, do up a cabinet note and move that facility under the Ministry of Science and Tertiary one time, because that is teamwork. No holding on to thing like it's yours. Remember, for y'all who don't understand, when the furor with Live Sport came up, and even though my name ain't calling, no audit, no nothing, Anil ain't touch nothing, Anil friend, wife, girlfriend, partner, nobody, nothing. Not like how small pin brother get lucky. Anil family didn't get lucky when he swearing to be a minister to get 3.625 billion. Small pins and them just get lucky. They do nothing wrong. I tell you, Edmund, no call nobody, no thief in no parliament and thing. Well, it's just pure luck. But you see, go Paul Luck and see Paul Luck. Because Anil Roberts' family didn't get nothing. But it's all right. That's okay. When I was on Spork, Gaia, the number one show in the history of Trinidad and Tobago, as far as sponsorship. Okay, there are shows that, like Ian Allen, when he was hot on TV6 and thing, had wider viewership and so on. But the number one show for sponsorship, anybody in media would know a Spork. I could have gone as Spork into Sports and Games once a month and take any shoe I want. as part of my personal endorsement of Sports and Games, who was a sponsor in my show. The same thing was also Ray Cool. I want to call in these names so all you could go and ask them. You know, in the 5 years of Spork, how many shoes I took from Sports and Games? 3 pairs. I could have taken 36 pairs of shoes, but I only took what I needed. I could have gotten a pair of Ray Cool shades from Glenn Jewelry. Ray Cool was a sponsor. Remember when I put on the shades and I'd go on the spot? Yes, I could have gotten a pair of shades every quarter. So I could have gotten 4 pairs of shades at a value of $3,000 each for each quarter. In that 3 year sponsorship, you know how many shades I took? 2. Only because I went Panorama and I lost one. So understand who is Anil Roberts and catch all your fast and out of place self, Judy Raymond, Miss Integrity. I keep asking you, answer all your questions. You put a front page. You know what? Let me tell all you what the story really was. The reporter called me Wednesday. Why my name? Jensen Levon. Me ain't want to blame me. It had nothing to do with he because he's a nice leader. Just ask questions. You know what was the first main question? Anil Roberts, we are hearing that you have been selected by Kamala Prasad Bisesa and the United National Congress Screening Committee to run for the Tuna Puna seat. Well, when I finished laughing, I said, boss man, that is totally false. That's a PNM propaganda. But it's all right. Tell them don't be afraid of Anil so. And Anil screen for anything that the boss want him do. If Kamala Prasad Bisesa say, Anil, shut down this douglAR politics, not helping the team. I done. If she say, screen for constituency executive. If she say, go and help Obika, down in point 14. I down there, putting diesel and driving. That's what a team does. So don't get frightened, PNM, about where Anil going. And talk about Anil, or you could talk about Anil 6 years now. Talk for 60 more years. You'll never find nothing. Let me tell you a little bit about Anil too, Judy Raymond. You picked war with the wrong person, you know. Since I small, I ain't war. Swimming was a white people's sport. It ain't a little douglAR boy coming to mash up the place. My father, as president of swimming in 1984, opened up primary school swimming. Now swimming, you could hardly see my white people and them. I mean, I love my Trini white people and thing, but all you know, it was a little unfair. All you had all your little selective thing, country club, Blue Dolphin, Marlins, you know, it was a little thing. But now, it opened wide for everybody. African, Indian, Syrian, white, Chinese, Venezuelan, everybody could swim. That because of my father, 1984, 82 to 85, president of swimming. So don't understand who Anil is. Black Lives Matter long time. All you forget, something very important, you know. When the furor came and Kamala Prasad Bisesa had taken a decision with all her ministers, Glenn Ramadasing, he behaved a little bad on the plane. Argue with the lady, but that's all. No money, no thiefing, no procurement, no $3.6, no $1 million apartment in Manhattan. None of that. No wife getting no building to rent for $7 million a year. None of that. No sitting down in a cabinet and giving, renting your own building and outfitting it for $61 million. None of that. He misbehaved. He apologized. Kamala said that's not good enough. Outside. And you know how good Glenn Ramadasing was performing? Direct impact. They had raised the number of poor people getting food cards from 16,000 up to 42,000. It's now back down under PNM to 18,000 pre-COVID. Kamala Prasad Bisesa, Chandra Sama, some girls say, some bacchanal in Grand Bazaar. Kamala say, Minister of Local Government, you have to resign because the people want Westminster style transparency. All of this Kamala do. And all your wicked newspapers and mass media label her corrupt. A man grabbed Pum Pum, threatened to grab Pum Pum. The girl said no. He fired the girl. And then when they realized water more than flour, take all your money and pay it, $150,000. He's still sitting down in the Parliament of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago. Do you all know after I resign, my name ain't calling nothing, no audit? Kamala Prasad Bisesa says, Anil, just like everybody else, if this is under you, go clear your name, clear everything. I say, ma'am, that's all you have to say. I resign. But all you forget, I also resigned as a member of parliament. Because I, Anil Roberts, said, and I still believe up to this day, a member of parliament is more important than a minister, even though the salary is smaller. Salary for MP is 13 or 14, well, the new thing, 15,000. Minister is all up after tax at 34,000 and so on. But the MP job is more important to me because you're actually helping people. You're meeting people and helping them get a little job, get a little bridge fixed, get the drain clean, get it spray, help them out. So I said, if I am not good enough, or I'm not acceptable enough to be a minister, I therefore do not believe I should be in the parliament. I resigned from as an MP. You have a woman on about how much charge walking up and down the criminal court slowly, holding on to the railing. She's still an MP and wanted to go back on screen. And all you want to vote for that because they pave all your road. All you get real. But the perception about Kamala was created by editors like Judy Raymond. Like the Express that had Asha Javed as the number one investigative journalist. While we now know she was loving up with Stuart Smallpin. Me and mine, if she liked the Smallpin, that's she business. But my problem is, love your Smallpin, but don't write politics that involve two sides. And Smallpin and them on one side. Then you can't be fair to this side if the pin on this side. How you gonna like this side? That's not fair, that's not just, that's not transparent, that's not ethical, that's not moral. On Life Spot alone, that Asha Javed write 27 front page of nonsense. You see how the perception comes? Remember when Olive say, if I say this, Olive go say corruption. Kamala some kind of outside, far, far away family, Gopal, who involved in trucking for 50 years. Kamala, the palace wasn't ready, Manning didn't move out yet, and Kamala didn't want to rush the man out because she have class, manners. Somebody say if Kamala know what it is to be poor. Kamala grew up poor in abject poverty. That's why her policies show love and care for poor people. Okay? All you don't get time, go and read a book. Kamala stay by Gopal. Sometime later, Kevin Ramnarayan is minister, not Kamala, Minister of Energy. Below that have a board of about eight to nine people of NP. Neil Gosain was the chairman, a man of integrity who run insurance company. And they had a contract, a tender, open tender, to communicate, to send out. And Gopal was in the tender. And Pomsite Rasta Fitzgerald Hines sat a ball. Oh, Kamala family, corruption, corruption. When I went back and researched last year, let me tell you all people, there were over 23 front pages saying Kamala, corruption, Gopal. There was over 24 minutes of TV6 News, and TV6 News was the number one. And at one point, it was like 260,000 people watching TV6 News. CNC3, and well, TTT, nobody's watch. Between those two, 24 minutes of prime time news, number one viewership, pumping the words Kamala, corruption. End of story. That's where the perception comes. No contract was ever even given out. And if there was anything, it had nothing to do with Kamala because there was process. There were people involved. There were Ministry of Finance rules that were followed. And all your balling Kamala thief, that is wrong. It is unfair. You have people now. Get Munilal clip ready there for me. You have in COVID, people sick, people want a grant and so on. The PNM is taking your money. The PNM is taking your money, taxpayers' money, and handing it to citizens without authority. To citizens who have no legal right to receive taxpayers' goods. All you feel a lie? Look, Archie, run Munilal there for me, please.
You get me, Madam Speaker, was when the Prime Minister stood here boldly and said, we are not about politics and campaigning. We are not about that at all, Madam Speaker. We are about serving and acting in a way that is not political. And, of course, accuse our party, our opposition, of behaving in a manner that Madam Speaker suggests to the Prime Minister that we took politics, we wanted to politicize this matter. Madam Speaker, I have in my hand here, distribution sheets for hampers, and today we are asking the Parliament to approve millions of dollars for social development programs, including food cards, including hampers, including other relief grants and so on, salary relief grants, what you call the rent grants and so on. That is the purpose of being here today. Madam Speaker, the government has to explain why it is during this period hampers are being distributed all over this country, and you like this one. When they are distributing hampers, they have the list here, and I have the list in my hand. The distribution list is in my hand here. Friday, 15th May 2020, hamper distribution list. This is what the person gets at the warehouse, and they get at the ministry, Namdevco, wherever it comes from. And they distribute according to a list sent by the government. And Siparia 50, Penal Junction, the office, the lady name is there and the number. Well, that clearly, Penal Junction opposite Penal Market, is a member of parliament for Siparia. But here it is. Another 15 Siparia to the Siparia Community Center, Kelvin Fletcher. Who is he? Madam Speaker, look at this. Point up here, Pleasants Park Community Center, Madam Speaker. 50, but point up here, 270 Hermitage Road, Union Village, Claxton Bay. 50, that is the office of the Member of Parliament for Point up here. Madam Speaker, Princess Tong. Two sets, one to the incumbent MP and one to the PNM candidates and PNM offices. Madam Speaker, it is here in the list, Komoto Manzanilla, you know, and the contact person. I'm not going to call contact person and so on. San Fernando West, Attorney General, 150 Independence Avenue, San Fernando, the person. Nothing wrong with that. But you know, none going to any UNC office down there. Why you didn't give 100 to Sean Sobers? You don't deserve none? Why don't give them?
Let me tell you all something. You all may think that is a small thing. Understand this. There are systems from the Ministry of Finance and the protocols of the public service regarding goods and services that are purchased with taxpayers' dollars to protect it. No one can just simply authorize food cards, as happened in Tabakit, or in this case, down all across the country, the PNM is sending taxpayers' money, goods for relief of citizens, to members of parliament and then to candidates that them select. A candidate of the PNM is a non-entity in the public service and has no authority whatsoever to receive anything to do with taxpayers' dollars unless they go and tender through a transparency process for the ability to provide goods and services. So handing out a candidate 50 of this, and suppose it was 30 wheelchairs at 10,000 each. Or y'all think it's just because it's food? The principle is the same, whether it is a pencil or a ferry from Austal and Incat. That is corrupt, that is wrong. And there are allegations there for the police to investigate. You see how it works? Judy Raymond, that's how it works. Understand, when Anil resigned as an MP and a minister, I gave up my salary. I gave it all up and all the perks and the power of being an MP. You have Grabby Wabby, Marlene, Camille, Drunky Monkey. A man who get convicted of driving drunk still sitting down in the Senate under Rowley. And you all say that Kamla did not carry an open, transparent. Imagine you all Kamla get rid of people too fast. And all you still flip the script on the lady and say she corrupt but Rowley good. Rowley who told Butch from Sandals when he was leader of the opposition playing golf. And this, he's such a dunce. He talk out this, you know. This is not Anil making up this. As much as I detest Rowley, I'll never lie on him. Rowley said it, go and read, that he boasts that when I was opposition leader, I met Butch, And I told him, well, I might be prime minister. I want you to develop a hotel in Tobago. He then became prime minister. Ignore the THA. Ignore procurement. Take Clico land surreptitiously and wanted to hand it to Butch without any tender. If you have a pristine piece of property like No Man's Land, any of y'all out there, including all your PNM, and you want the best deal for it, wouldn't you put out an international tender and a request for proposals saying, look at this, No Man's Land, 400 acres of pristine land surrounded by the most beautiful Caribbean golden water, the golden sands and the blue turquoise water, break, no waves, calm waters, to the east is a lagoon. Who wants it? And let all the billionaires and big corporations bid and fight up for it, and then you rock back and choose the best one for the people of Trinidad and Tobago? No, Rowley's procurement was, Butch is my friend. I talk to Butch. I tell Butch, I's the boss. Small pin, tell Butch. We giving him land. We going to borrow $7 billion. We will build it for him. Let him design it, you know, because we don't want to build thing he don't like. Then we going to give him tax breaks, PAYE breaks, and customs and duties of alcohol. And you all say, yes, Rowley. Yes, Landate. Yes, Renaissance. Yes, Emailgate. Yes, Rowley, you go, boy, because you is the Mother Teresa of Trinidad and Tobago. And about Kamala Thief, y'all are disgusting if y'all say that. Because Judy Raymond and her newspaper pumped that perception down your throat, whether she was at The Guardian. At The Guardian, she had the same feelings as she has now, you know. Let me give you one more. Little story about Annele. When I was 9 years old, they had to raise money in Marlin Swim Club down there in Westmoreland, St. Anthony's Pool. Because it wasn't like when Annele was minister and money was there to support. We had to go and do fundraising, car wash, all kind of thing, barbecue, curry-cue, and we have something called a swimathon, where we would go out and get people, parents in the school, everybody, and say, all right, I'm going to swim for 2 hours. Give me, how much you're gonna give me? $5 per length, $10 per length, $2 per length, and however many lengths you swim in 2 hours, you multiply that on your sheet, and you raise funds to go to represent the country, wherever the swimming meet is. They had a boy called Red Cheeping, who was about 2-3 years above me. He was at that time the baddest, fastest man. In Trinidad, he break all 12 records. Winning, beating people, bad, bad, bad. So I was a small man to him. But we used to be training hard. I want to be like he. So I didn't have the skill and thing like George Bovell and Shastri Roberts and them. But I like to walk hard. So swimathon going. And 2 hours pass. Well, some people drop out after 20 minutes, 30 minutes. Me and Red trying to clock. Racing up and down to see who could get the most lengths to get the most money. When 2 hours done, Jappy Cheeping and Choco Aloy blowing the whistle, tweet, 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 stop, stop, stop. I look at he look at me. He has stop, well, I has stop. He has stop, well, I has stop. They blowing the whistle, everybody saying, well, stop, time to play football, time to barbecue. I look at he has stop, I has stop. He has stop, I has stop. Both of we swim 5 hours straight. You know how they stop we? All the other swimmers who done, jump on both of we the same time and stop we. Because I didn't want to lose and he didn't want to lose. So, Judy, whether you really feel you want war with me? Girl, go and smile, skin up your face by Rowley and cool yourself, eh? And Mr. Castani, my PNM brother, I ask you if that is what you want for your newspaper. Because people are now, it done drop already. And now it might drop out of existence. You keep fighting for Judy Raymond while all your good reporters and everybody else have been thrown and cast aside. So now, Vishnu Kunkun, Alan Karim, get ready. I want all of you to take this clip and before I even done douglAR politics, fling it on the Facebook. You see Judy Raymond? You should have leave Anil alone. You see, small pin? Don't call my name, boy. You see, because where I sit in a high place looking down at scum like you, small pin. okay, while you looking at your brother's brilliance, he's the best CEO in the whole wide world. He must be so smart. But then he admitted in his little response that he only have his first degree, unless he got a PhD in 3 years. I don't know. So a man who not so bright, just so lucky to get $3.625 billion in work when his brother Smallpin swear on the Bible to be Rowley's Gary Sobers. All right. Alan Karim, Kun Kun, are you ready, Vishnu? Okay. Judy Raymond, this is for you. I answer all your questions. Right? You start off asking if I go in for Tuna Puna, they drop David naked in on your tail. Don't worry, Esmond Ford. Just run now, boy. Go and try and get in at Seat in Lavanti or something, because David naked don't take that. And then the other question was, and the reporter was so nice, you know, he said, Anil Ashaw is political mischief, you know. But they said the police want to investigate and want to interview. Police could interview anybody at any time. Like police. Love the police. Afraid no police. So Judy Raymond, I want you now to answer some of my questions. Since I answer all yours. You see, the douglAR afraid no question. Let me make sure I'm looking good. You ready? Alan Karim, Vishnu Kun Kun. Press record. Judy Raymond, I answered all your questions on your Newsday toilet paper. Therefore, it should follow that you reciprocate with the same accountability, transparency, ethics, and journalistic integrity, propriety, and impartiality. Let me ask you the following questions. Is Jeffrey Gillen a longtime friend of Keith Christopher Rowley? Is Jeffrey Gillen on a PNM state board appointed by Keith Rowley's cabinet? Is or was Jeffrey Gillen part of Woodgill Limited, who Keith Christopher Rowley granted outline approval to, outline planning approval in August of 2003 while he was the Minister of Integrated Planning and Development under Patrick Manning's government? Did this outline approval granted by ministerial approval, I have the letters still, you know, signed by Keith Christopher Rowley, yeah? Earlier, douglAR don't play. Did this outline approval clear the way and access to financing for Mr. Jeffrey Gillen and Joseph Rahal, son of Rowley's friend, John Rahal, to increase the value of the land at Shorelands from $10 million to those two buildings that at last check were valued at approximately $850 million. Did Keith Rowley do that? Were you married or in a close married relationship and produced children with the same Jeffrey Gillen? Did you? Is that true? Was Keith Christopher Rowley at your wedding? Did he frequent your house for limes, parties, celebrations, New Year's, birthdays, anniversaries? How would you describe your friendship with Keith Christopher Rowley, Miss Judy Raymond? Are y'all acquaintances? Professional, writer, journalist, politician relationship? Are y'all close friends? Are you like family? Are you intimate friends? Or are you soulmates? Please choose one of those to let the population know. What's the relationship over the years that you have with Keith Christopher Rowley? Do you accept the importance of the fourth estate, Judy Raymond, as you control a newspaper and control the perception of the population who has to make decisions on who to elect and where to put their vote? Do you accept the importance of the fourth estate being impartial, operating under the strictest principles of journalism? Do you believe, adhere to, and live daily the tenets of journalistic integrity, Judy Ray? Put up she face there for me, Archie. And finally, Miss Judy Raymond, editor of the Newsday that just let go 40 employees and about three or four of them have you in court, owned by Mr. Castani, who is not of this ilk. Mr. Castani, PNM Castani, is a man of caliber, a good man, I'm telling you all you. He might be the only PNM I respect. Finally, Judy Raymond. You does line with Kamala too? We coming back.
Right now, the UNC virtual political platform is the most watched online.
Should you call these elections while thousands of citizens of our country are outside of the country? You take away their right to vote.
We are the voice for the voiceless and those who have been left out and left behind.
They shut down TDC. Hundreds sent home. ArcelorMittal shut down. Thousands more unemployed. Petrotin shut down. A lying prime minister. Lying prime minister who said the government is not shutting down Petrotin.
Watch us, like us, stay with us. The United National Congress virtual campaign on the ballot. 7:30 p.m. Thursday on this station. Why wait? Now is the time.
Welcome back to douglAR Politics. Now we move in. Share the live, because now it's relaxing. Judy Raymond, I didn't do that just for you. You're so special, girl. Oh, Lord. Dr. Bishnu Raghunath, remember I call his name? Remember last week, Tuesday, I did 2 hours and 15 minutes explaining why Maxi Coffee might be the biggest dunce in the history of Trinidad and Tobago? Where the PNM once again is trying to say, never mind we suffer the entire country. Never mind we ignored all our supporters. Never mind we took away everything that Kamala had for poor people. From children, life fund, to baby grant, to laptop, to textbook. We cut school feeding. We even cut food. We cut special needs, Rowley and them. And then Maxi Coffee writes the most racist, ridiculous remarks. And Keith Christopher Rowley up to now has not distanced himself. He has not condemned those remarks. The PNM did. Laurel is a lovely. Oh, gosh, look at next nice PNM. I mean, but she getting confused. I find two good PNM today. That's very good. But Laurel is a don't get involved in that now. You know you don't agree with Maxi Coffee. You put out a statement. But we don't want to hear from you. Because Maxi Coffee was not representing the PNM. Maxi Coffee saw on the Bible and is a member of Parliament of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago and a parliamentary secretary in the Ministry of Public Administration draws in a pay for no work for the last 3 years and also receiving $2.5 million to save his life. And then he cast aspersions on Indian people. Maxi Coffee, what a skunks. So Raghunath, now I asked Dr. Bishnu Raghunath, he was the head of some I don't even know the name of the organization, for proper political, ethical conversation and so on. But I realized Dr. Bishnu Raghunath is a joke, because the only time he does talk is if Munilal say something wrong. You understand? Anytime Rowley, Maxi Coffee, Camille, Fitzgerald Hines, Pumsite Rasta, anytime them say anything, Bishnu Raghunath quiet. So the whole Maxi Coffee debacle 2 weeks ago. Here Raghunath this time. The Council for Responsible Political Behavior is advising all political parties across to abide by the Constitution as the country faces a general election. Let me tell you something, Bishnu Raghunath. You want to be a clown and you don't want to do your job fairly, then don't tell me nothing, boy. You feel anybody respect you? You're playing games with serious business. Dr. Keith Christopher Rowley attacked Kamala. When Kamala said, listen, you playing, Rowley, election on your mind, Rowley. Do not play that you and small pain keeping border closed and keeping citizens out from exercising their franchise under some COVID-19 that we ain't no COVID-19. 15 weeks, if all you believe these statistics, then we're always closing the border and think for why we only had 116 cases. Well, they say they find somebody, okay, all of a sudden to close the border longer. Kamala say, listen, you cannot disenfranchise one vote. She didn't say let in the UNC, you know. She said let every citizen come home to exercise their most important duty in selecting a government. Rowley bonfire on Kamala. I don't know how he's get very arrogant and vexed, like when he's talking to a woman like he and Roger, they have a problem with woman. Me, you know, like, they have a problem with intelligent, strong, disciplined woman. You and Roger. Don't tell. I had to do some good investigation and check out you, Roger, and Small Pain, what really going on, eh? So, Archie, you ready, eh? Oh, Lord, you ready? So, Rowley say, election not on our mind. We have more important things to do. We have to see about the health and the care and the lives of citizens of Trinidad and Tobago. Election is not on my mind, said Rowley. Play.
The position arrived at is that there were two competing positions. One, which is to have the exams as early as possible, and the parents and students prefer that option. The other was tutors' option, which is to have the exam in October. Madam Speaker, if the elections, keep saying elections, if the examination...
Oh, you catch me. Oh, Lord, election not on your mind. We're talking SEA. And all you say thank you to the douglAR, all the SEA parents, say thank you, douglAR. Because if all you was watching this show before, you know for the last 2 weeks, upon them, they're doing all kind of things. They're opening all kind of things. They're making sure their friend and their manufacturing open. They're making sure. I say, what about my little children and the parents who suffering with this SEA exam that is like a big boulder resting on the children's brain? All you ain't do nothing for them. Remember Anthony Garcia went and visit QRC to see if them ready. Anthony Garcia, QRC, Fatima, Presentation, Naparima, Astra Girls, Lakshmi Girls, Shagwanas, Senior Cup, them, schools always ready. You have to go and see about my success, Lavanti, my Marabella, all of my schools down in Labrie in Point 14. Go and see that they are ready. They need the most assistance. That is why, let me just ask you all something serious. Election coming, right? I've already told you all, Tim Gopi Singh and Kamala, how well they did between 2010 and 2015 in education. All you know it, I don't have to tell all you again. The screening process of the People's National Movement has removed from consideration, thereby firing both ministers of education. Lovell Francis get bust throat for a UNC gypsy hair, resign yet, you know. I'm waiting for the letter. Dave Tanku, tell me if Gypsy send a letter. He going up, he going up. Yellow and red make orange. Vasant. Vasant, I ain't going to bother with you. Vasant, you say you are not on, you are different sides of the political divide. So Gypsy is on one side and you on the next side. Which side you on? You not on UNC side and the divide is only two sides. It's not a triangle, Vasant. Vasant, oh, I won't even bother with you now. But let me get back to the point. Lovell Francis gets spit out. Minister in the Ministry of Education, Dr. Lovell Francis, who does call everybody dunce. And now in Arima, the Honorable Sleepy Man, the Honorable, what his name? Garcia. Related to Noel, I spend all your money because me and Rowley, good guys here, has been rejected from Arima. So Dr. Rowley has fired both ministers of education because they perform good. Huh? They were so great that he fired both. Don't worry, all your vote for them, they go pave all your road. So Winford James, remember I tell all of this, Dr. Bishnu Raghunath and Winford James now find Rowley arrogant, he bold-faced, he dismissive, he disrespectful with the Tobago self-government bill. So he write a whole column, but he failed to remind the population that when Kamala brought the Tobago self-governance bill, that Keith Christopher Rowley, whether with permission, I don't know, he either got permission from Winford James to use Winford James' column previously written in the week of that debate on a Wednesday, I believe, and debate was Friday, And he used Winfred James 6 points in the exact order with the exact numbers at the same time with the same punctuation. That is who Ollie have as Prime Minister. A man so dotish and lazy he cannot even write his own contribution to his island where he born. But vote for them, they come in and pave your road, it could be smooth just now. Vote for that, it's okay. Winfred James then says, no, I never heard, and I asked about 12 times over the last 7 years, if Winfred James gave him permission. So it's either Winfred James gave him his position, and Rowley did not give Winfred James credit. You see, very important. When you quote from someone, you have to give them credit, especially if you quote verbatim. Rowley didn't do that. Go and check the Hansard. So it leads me to believe that Rowley plagiarized Winfred James. You see? Because you did not give him credit. And you're using his exact words. Do you know there's a little situation now that I've seen on Facebook? It seemed like Rowley might have done this again. There's a student who went to share some information with Rowley, and she's saying that the exact words and her exact work from UWE, her thesis, is being bandied about by the PNM all over the place. Well, let me tell you, young lady, go and check the Hansard of that debate. It might help your case. So, we have another video, you know, because they say vote, eh? We going and vote. And the douglAR say, don't vote on no race, because you had nothing to do with your race. Your mother and father fall in love. Your father drop some lyrics. Your mother laugh, and he eventually get through. And you pop out. You had nothing to do with that. So how that could be so important? Vote on policy. Vote on performance. So like in education, Rowley fire he own 2 ministers. Kamala big up she minister. Plus, when she was the Minister of Education under Bastio, was the best too. So you had 2 good ministers of education in the UNC in the yellow. How you going to vote for 2 good and you're voting for 2 fired? Nah, man. So here's another reason to vote. And this is a key seat. They have a convent girl. He wearing screen in front of his face and thing. A convent girl going up in St. Joseph. The army man coming to hunt him, hey, he go hunt. But if you're going to hunt, at least talk like a man. I'm going to hunt. They all sing, are you a pharmacologist? You ain't show me a degree, I keep asking you. Or are you just a druggist? You're so jealous of them doctors and they will ride you brighter than you. Don't you feel? If you talk with Queen's English, we will feel you bright. Run D.D. I'll sing, let me see if he bright.
There is no specific treatment. There is no cure, there is no vaccine for COVID-19. We have in stock, as your member for Clarny East will know, Faizabad and Bharatar Sharma, who could advise you that you treat flu-like symptoms, whether it's H1N1, influenza B, or COVID, symptomatically. So, for instance, if the person has shortness of breath, you will give them bronchodilators and oxygen. We have that. If their blood pressure is dropping, you give them medication to do that. There is no specific silver bullet drug, pill, tablet, injection, vaccine, anywhere in the universe. Mars, Saturn, Uranus, Jupiter, the sun or the moon, to treat with coronavirus. You treat the patients symptomatically and you support them.
On the total to date of 589.
My question, Minister, is that given the small amount of people who are quarantined versus that people who are tested, do you think $45 million, etc., is value for money?
Okay, so let me give you one example, because I was shocked when I got this figure this morning. When we were looking, and I have the figure here, one of the drugs that we have to use, and you will know, is a drug called human globulin immune. You know, each patient that we have to put on that costs between $100,000 to $200,000 per patient.
Well, you could take a jersey and make a mask. All you don't go by the private testing. 21 days later, all you go and get all your tests by the private. Oh, we getting 4,000 testing kits. Oh God, they work, they malfunctioning. Convent girl, let me ask you something. Which one is the truth? That in Mars and Jupiter there's no medicine necessary, then you pay 100,000 to 200,000 per patient? Let me do some maths for you. Let me take the Alsing. This warrior, them one, they, St. Joseph, that who them want to vote for, or they don't make me laugh, you know. So let's take the USA for example. The USA have not been monitoring, but last check they have about 400,000 positive cases, right? Because they're testing. Now Donald Trump said, if I stop testing, we'll have no cases. Well, we know that because the Alsing and them are testing since the beginning. And all they're telling me that, oh, we flattened the curve. It didn't have a curve. Anyway, so 400,000 cases in the US. At 34,000 US per patient, like 200,000 TT, right? Check the USA bill. If what the Alsing say is true, and all these patients need this expensive, the thing costing more than surgery, but it have nothing that work, eh? This is not a miracle cure. This is not a vaccine. This is not a injection and boom, we going down and we partying and we swimming by the beach, eh? This is the druggist telling all you, and want all you vote for him. The U.S. bill, if they were utilizing the Alsing figures and his drugs as a druggist, would be $13.6 billion U.S. dollars. $13.6 billion U.S. Convent girl, tell me something different, eh? Now, I kept telling y'all, because y'all trying to say, okay, first and foremost, let me try it this way. Let me go with Rowley rhetoric. They handled COVID. Rowley was brilliant. He was amazing. He was the best in the world. The Oxford study by the student. Don't worry that everybody said it. That's not about implementation. That was just about lockdown policy. And it was just a student at Oxford. Like, and you know them are so bright because we talk about Judy Raymond already, right? Let me pretend. The douglAR is saying, oh Lord Rowley, COVID-19, you did a bang up fantastic job, you're the best. Okay, so you've been in government 4 years and 10 months, and you were good for 2 months. What about the other 4 years and 8 months? You're saying that COVID was not about election. We all said, Kamla say, UNC say, the douglAR say, Anils, I say we could never, since it was coming from Wuhan in end of November, December, we know it's spreading Italy, Europe, and it's coming. All of us said the thing is, we can't blame the PNM for COVID. So we would not have, it would not have been political. But you started the politics some one time. But let's start, number one. Okay, Rowley, you are fantastic. You did great on COVID. So let's vote for you because you handled something that might never come back in 100 years. Well, here what we go do. Next time it have a pandemic, we go call you Rowley. All right? The douglAR solve the problem. Next time it have a pandemic, we call in Rowley. Now let me get serious. Other than the no testing, like what Trump say, if you don't test, you have no curve and you have no cases, right? I already told y'all. COVID-19 coronavirus presents two problems. You have to deal with both. So if you handle this and we don't have much spread and so on, we don't know because we are tests. But let's say that, throw that still. This is the one now. If we had none, then you don't need to lock down. You don't need to shut down. You don't need to put harsh economic measures and sufferation on the entire population. You don't need 18% of your businesses to shut down and not ever open back. You don't need 400,000 people, daily paid workers, to not make money for 16 weeks. You don't need to do that. You have to have the brain to do a hybrid with testing, tracing, proper spacing, and keep the economy going. So to just shut down makes no sense. It's like if you're picking a cricket team, right? In a cricket team, you would know you need some batsmen, you need some all-rounders, and you need some bowlers. So if Rowley and Dyal Singh and them was in charge of picking our cricket team, them go only pick bowlers. So everybody could bowl, so because they solve one part. So don't worry about no batting, just bowl. Well, you all pick that. So Rowley says, we have done so well on the economic side. People are lying. All of you out there are lying about not getting your salary grants. But Carl Mimbert said 6 days ago that 20,000 people have received their $1,500 grant. He said 51,000 people applied. Well, Colm, that means 31,000 didn't get. You clung. And not only that, you didn't promise them just 1,500, which is not really 1,500, because some people get in 1,350, some get 1,150, some get 1,200. But let me leave it at 1,500. You didn't promise them 1,500. You promised them 4,500. So you have only done 20,000 out of 153,000. So there are 133,000 people who did not get their money. But you're calling people liars. Let's see. Government pays out 20,000 in grants. That was the import. Massey Motors furloughs 68, rotates 35. Furlough is a big word for kind of fire. Give them a little rest. And if things pick up, they go hire them back. Is that handling everything good? People losing job all around. Lifestyle Motors adjust staff too. Company Oilfield Workers Trade Union executive member Ernesto Quezar says some employers are using the COVID-19 pandemic to send home people. That's just one paper. Rowley, unhappiness in the whole country, stakeholders unhappy over school card distribution. There were 48,000 children in the school feeding program. Up to a month ago, and there's been no increase, Camille Robinson Regis has boasted that 20,000 children got food cards. Well, that means 28,000 still hungry, all you silly people. The ILO panel says Caribbean must avoid labor pandemic. Because you see, the pandemic is not just lockdown and who don't get sick. The economic devastation, especially for us, we were in economic devastation before COVID. Rowley had sucked out everything. Kamala left $12.26 billion in reserves. It's down to under $7 billion. She was at 14 months import cover. It's down to 8 months. Kamala left $7 billion in the heritage. They say they ain't touch it yet, but they go in and touch it for election to pave your road. Vote for them. They said labor pandemic coming. Parents and daycare operators affected by continued closure. So all the daycare, all the Montessori, all them people suffering. And you all say you handle it good? This is just some article that I didn't pull all, you know. COVID-19 kills South Business Express. Friday, 5th June, COVID-19 pandemic has forced as much as 15% of retail businesses to shut down. Police called out as 100 seek hampers. How people hungry? They're so hungry, police had to come out. Y'all did so good, vote for y'all because you handled COVID. Forget the 4 years and 8 months. Deal with the 2 months of COVID and police have to keep our citizens in order because they're hungry. You all really serious? A hamper distribution hosted by Our Lady of Perpetual Help Roman Catholic Church yesterday drew groups of needy people to the church's compound. All you must be saying, boy Anil, you pull an article from back in April when the thing now start. Daily Express, Thursday 11th June. Thursday 11th June. Central Bank predicts more job losses. And that Central Bank governor, Anil Dogla, telling you, he's a PNM. You want to know why? Remember when you had to go and change your $100 notes? The government cannot instruct a central bank governor anything to do with the money supply. The central bank governor is an independent institution on the head. He is in charge of monetary policy, which deals with the supply of money, which deals with the repo rates, which adjust in banks and so on to make sure if the supply, if there's a lot of money in the system, you could suck some out so that inflation would not go up. And the monetary policy of a central bank governor is to go, is to work against any fiscal problems of the government. The government is in charge of fiscal policy. This central bank governor who replaced douglAR, who went calling him but in court because he not only fired him but denied him an opportunity to fly the red, white and black outside, and them calling people like us unpatriotic because we disagree with Rowley and his bag of Convangale dunces pretending to be men parading all across the country. I unpatriotic. Swim for the country, football for the country, coach for the country, Olympic medal, Pan American, double gold, double silver. I unpatriotic. What small pin do other than sit down in a commission of inquiry and defend douglAR and make money, money, money? Swearing as a government minister, sit down by Rowley and he brother make money, money, money. He father with the old self, out of retirement, can't even walk, I see him in Westmoreland, had to stop and let him go ahead. I don't even want to see him. Because if I blow too hard, he might fall down. But still actively, Sagico, he was on the board of Sagico. Call me, but say Maritime Financial is not a known company and does not have the track record. And Sagico is a local company. Sagico is a Barbados company and now is a Canadian company. What local? But Richard Young was on the board. They buy the Clico portfolio for $300 million less than Maritime bid. How y'all work out that? Judy Raymond, what's that? The country don't need money? Spit out $300 million and give them it? Who going to share up that that benefits? We're going to share it up in cake? So the central bank governor, who in December last, when all you had to line up granny's faint away because they had to take their little kakada and go and change it under the guise of, we're going to find all this corruption and drugs and guns and money. They find a pastor and they go out and give back the pastor the money because tithe's not illegal. Even if the pastor convicted of all the charges, you know what is the highest penalty the pastor could get? The 28 million pastor. You feel 28 million, oh my God, he could get 10 years, 15 years, 20 years in Golden Grove. He loses NGO because he failed to have audited accounts 1 year, and it's not even that late, because THA had no audited accounts when we was in government in 2010 to 2015. The PNM THA didn't have audited accounts since 2003. All you're going to want to lock up a pastor for 1 year? And he guilty. All they will do is take away his NGO. And this central bank governor, on your TV, go back and check, don't take the douglAR word for it. He went and said, well, the government's national security policy will mean that we have to do this in 2 weeks because of the... That's not your work, boy. You not in the cabinet, the central bank governor. The national security policy of the government has nothing to do with you. You are the man in charge of the monetary policy and the monetary supply. And if you decide that we're using it and we're doing it the normal way, 3 months, 4 months, slack in, slack out, then that's your work. Your work is not to take instructions from no executive. All your clowns will get permission and just mash up the country. And what Judy Raymond and them say? Anything? What Dr. Winford James say? Dr. Bishnu Raghunath? What all these fellas who are more intelligent than me? Where you all read the columns? You all probably even wondered, but how did douglAR know that? But hear the joke now. I went through all of that, right? All you out there feeling the pain. Even all your PNM people. Feeling the pain. I know watching douglAR politics feel the pain because, oh God, the information is just bunny. You can't say nothing except Anil ugly, he's sweating, he's stupid. Okay. But deal with Anil information. Put a counter argument. But you can't, because you can't change facts. Facts are stubborn things. So let me ask you all out there who in pain, who businesses in pain, who getting thrown out, who getting evicted, who business cannot open, who's suffering, who get fired, who get retrenched. A man who is telling y'all that y'all are ungrateful and plenty of people get the grants, even though I just went through that with y'all, he is now saying, as elections are not on his mind, that he wants y'all to vote for him. Okay? And hear what this clung says. And I have to use the word clung. It's a very strong word. Some of y'all may say, Anil, that's a bit harsh. But when I read this, you'll understand. This clung called Keith Christopher Rowley, in understanding all of y'all who are on the ground and know the pain, suffering, the drop in GDP, the aggregate demand that has disappeared, the perfect storm that is coming to crash an economy that was already crashed. Hear what Rowley say. And think about this. When you going to dip your finger, you know, forget who black, who Indian, who Douglas, who Syrian, who Chinese, who Venezuelan. Forget that, you know. Forget who is man, woman. Forget who is Hindu, Muslim, Catholic, Jah, Rastafari, Baptist, Orisha. Forget all that, you know. Think about who you're going and vote for. Hear the man who want all you to vote for him. Prime Minister, optimistic. Economy will recover by August 1st. Rowley said on Saturday, the government, this is from the Newsday. Had to be the Newsday. It really is the Newsday. Newsday, Section A, Sunday, June 7th, 2020. Judy Raymond, you wasn't bright enough to don't print that. Or if you print it, put the truth. After it, put about six different economists. If you find, Judy Raymond, one economist to agree with this abject stupidity that the economy of Trinidad and Tobago, which was in tatters pre-COVID, after 2.5 months of total lockdown, is going to recover by August 1st. If you find one human being other than the clown Rowley to make that statement, I tell my people, buy back the Newsday. If you don't print it, all out there, we not buying Newsday. I have to buy it. I go buy it and tell all you what in it, right? We not buying it. Let me just finish off here. Two last points. I went on long today because I had real topics to go. Keith Christopher Rowley said election is not on his mind. The pandemic handling is not about election. It's not about campaigning. I show all your evidence throughout the show about that. It lied. But all of them went in the parliament Friday and everyone was saying, look how we handle COVID, vote for us. Look how we handle COVID, vote for us. We handle COVID, vote for us. We number one in the world, vote for us. Bringing information to you that was not factual. That little stupid Oxford report was not based on anything. I keep telling you all, y'all must deal with science and not innuendo and rumor. How can a student in England do a study with detailed information down here? And then they had to come out and say, well, we weren't talking about implementation. We were just talking about what them want to do. Okay, but then the Alsing say, we go in and test 10,000 people. 3 months ago, he said that we have only tested 3,335 out of a population of 1.4 million, with the minimum testing level being 38,000. Only he realized that's incompetence. Well, a real report came out. The Forbes magazine, you all know Forbes. Forbes don't play. Forbes is do anything with money, economy, anything, and have their researchers, and they don't play their brand. It has been the number one business financing magazine for the last 50 years. Every investor, every businessman, anybody on the stock market, they read Forbes. They don't play. It come like a staple. Anytime you see a businessman, a money man, and he's drinking coffee, it must have a Forbes. It could have others, The Economist and so on and so forth, but it must have a Forbes. Could have a Wall Street Journal, all kind of thing. Forbes printed a survey conducted by the Deep Knowledge Group. The name and all, you know, Rowley and them can't read that. Deep Knowledge Group, okay? Trinidad and Tobago is not in the top 100. Bahamas is number 100. Trinidad and Tobago is 168th in their ranking of the overall impact and implementation of COVID-19 response. This survey was done from 11,400
data points. Do you understand the amount of information and data that had to come in to come into that ranking? That is a survey, not the MFAO survey that say Rowley and them do good. 8 out of 10 people love Rowley. It print in June, on June 10th. You know when them Trinity, that survey was? April 27th to May 10th. And them printed, Express printed and Newsday printed in June 10th to tell us what's going on. And that's not science. A survey is no good a month later. A month later, you know how much thing, you know how much people are hungry in that month? You know how much children starve? You know how much people under pressure? You know how much domestic abuse went up? You know how much suicide happened? You know the pressure people feeling in that month? So, that's a real survey. And that's about correct. Rowley is about 168 out of 207 countries. Because what about the competitive index, for example? Kamala left us when she left in 2015. We were 66th in the world in ease of business. Like, if you want to come and invest and think, 66. Rowley carried us to 106 out of 140. The corruption index, we are 88 with Smallpin and Rowley out of 118. So 168 out of 207 is about Rowley's level of competence. Not number one in the world. Boy, them could lie with a straight face. Eh? Final question for Rowley and for all of y'all who are going to vote in election. Why is it that Keith Christopher Rowley and his government always finding some fly-by-night company to do business with? Why would you do that? If you are serious, you wouldn't you? Isn't business about high performance, quality, great service, track record, history, less risk? Isn't that on those the principles of business? So when you're spending taxpayer money, wouldn't you look for companies like that? Here's some of the companies Rowley and them like to use. EOS Trading to sell gas. Who's EOS Trading? It's in Geneva, Switzerland. A total selling gas, you know. Gas is $1 billion, $1 trillion industry. Them find a small company with a total annual revenue of $750,000 to sell a shipload of gas to a man named Rumperti. And didn't realize Rumperti, Venezuela Rumperti, right? Bridgemans, when they went to get ferry, all over the world, so many international companies of great stature, great balance sheet, great experience, great technology, great workers and so on. And Rowley and them gone and find Bridgemans. Up to now, Mark Bassant can't even find Bridgman's office. The Chinese contract for Rowley was Minister of Housing that Newman George signed. Newman George, you'd have signed plenty bad thing, boy. The 289-page contract with the sweetheart deal for this Chinese. Where he find that Chinese company when he went China? How he find that company? It's a big company. It have companies, Shanghai, China, Railway, and things who doing work a long time. Where Rowley went and find this small one that nobody know about? What about NCB Global Finance right there where we just drink rum by Frankie's? You mean NCB Global Finance has a better track record than Republic Bank? One of the best banks in the Western Hemisphere? Scotia Bank? RBC? I mean, RBC's service is woeful, but still, track record. Ansa Merchant Bank, backing of the Ansa Corporation that made last year in a quarter $1.604 billion pre-tax profit. NCB Global Finance, a little parlor thing. Rowley gone and give them $3.625 billion of all your money in work. How? Then, patriotic to buy all your refinery. Patriotic do him have money to buy a flag. Them going and find $13 billion. Understand the assets of Petrotrin, the refinery, are encumbered to creditors, you know. So before any refinery open up, you had to pay $13 billion. You're down in a hole. You had to pay that $13 billion and climb up before you start, you know. Where Roger? And Roger, I'll go deal with you after. Where Roger and Patriotic going to find $13 billion plus extra to open a refinery? But Rowley and them do business with Patriotic, a company that now form. And finally, they get a vessel from Malta. I thought Malta was only a drink, a brown drink, and a drink to stay healthy and get vitamin B. Them went Malta and bring Lavalette. Now remember when they came in 2015, the mantra was Kamala corruption, KD's corruption, Galicia corruption. The Galicia was 14,500 euros per day. So if that had corruption, what about the 34,500 euros per day for this Lavalette, the Jean Lavalette? That extra 20,000 euros per day, that are no corruption, because Rowley is the bastion of integrity. But all they don't mind, you know, they come in to pave a road near you. So vote for them when they pave your road. God bless. I went long. Good night. Check out all them other boys. Mark Reeves. Check out Brian Stone. Check out Winston Ragu and them going live. My boy, God, Christopher. No borders. All you check them out and get the information. Grung report on the morning. Information. I'm forgetting some people. But just find information because you need information to vote. Don't vote for Anil because he's a douglAR. Vote because he's the best minister of sport in the history of Trinidad and Tobago. I thank Mr. Valentino Singh, the greatest editor, sport editor in Trinidad and Tobago, for your kind words, sir. God bless. Good night. Stay safe.
And justice, everyone is fighting for equal rights. And justice, Palestinians fighting.